Mountain House in Alberta, jumper extraordinaire, Curt Browning. He was sixth in his first Olympic Games.
With the most international renowned skaters, one thing that always comes across is the personality. It hits you right between the eyes. He's got it. That was unfortunate for Curt. He did it so well in Calgary. A triple axel, the most difficult combination. Nevertheless, there's a little more to the program than just the combination, but it will cost him. Had he not made that mistake, he earned his reputation in Calgary, where he brought down the house. This will not be as high as it was, but it was definitely a quality program.
Curt just said, sitting there, I should have jumped then, and I jumped then, meaning he jumped a little too late, and that's where he's paying in this first set of marks, the technical for that slight thing. I'm sure his second set of marks will be much higher. And they are a 5-6 from Denmark and Austria and the Soviet Union, and those are the highest marks we have seen so far, and still with a lot of skaters to come. About 11 of them, he is sitting first in the short program. Curt Browning is Mr. Excitement. He does everything, and that will include a quad tonight. He should go all out, all or nothing. And Toller, you spoke to him just a few moments ago.
Yes, I did. He's very concentrated, very calm, and a very determined young man. Difficult to actually determine a triple and a quad that had a slight three turn behind it. But if we remember Vern Taylor's triple axel in Ottawa, the first on record, he also had a three turn behind it. Triple axel followed that quad. I don't know where the energy comes from, because if it were me, I think I just sort of finished the performance right there. Combination, a triple saukow a mile high, followed by a double loop. Curt Browning has catapulted into the A group in 1 year. One could also say in one competition, the Olympics in Calgary, where he astounded the entire audience. the evening continues like this, they'll simply run out of jumps and certainly run out of marks. A triple-triple combination. Kurt is an exponent of the new breed of skating, of which there are very few, but they are the super athletes and also athletes with great personality and charisma. The other that comes to mind would have to be Viktor Petrenko, bronze medalist in the Olympics in Calgary. Program leaves something to be desired. It doesn't have the slickness of an Orser or a Boitano. That will all come, but athletically, there are few skaters that could ever compete with that kind of technique. It was really one of a kind. Probably can't get the very highest marks, but this will be one of the superior performances tonight, for sure.
And he's getting a standing ovation, certainly from all the Canadians, and I think there are more Canadians than any other nationality other than the Hungarians here. More Canadians than Americans, I'm sure. Certainly more Canadian flags. A big contingent over from the Armed Forces base in Laarwes, Germany. And look at this.
That's Elizabeth Manley and Christine Huff. This was the quad. Only the most discerning eye could see it. For many people in the audience wouldn't really have twigged on the fact that it was a quad. Followed, I think, by the triple axel. Any one of these jumps can, a program can be built around. They are so extremely difficult. They appear to be easy, but the risk is phenomenal.
First set of marks coming out for Kurt Browning, who obviously seemed to enjoy himself too out there. We'd watched him in practice doing, oh yes, 1 foot, he says. Doggone right, it was 1 foot. We've watched him with those quads in practice. And
meet you at the airport.
Talking about them here all day today. Judges have obviously been wondering a little bit.
Well, a Kurt Browning is a wild card that comes into the competition too early to allow the 5'9s and 5'8s to come out, I think. But certainly, it was a very leveling kind of performance, and many, many people will snap to attention and realize that this is one of the great potential champions for the future.
And the first set of marks now are coming up. 5'7" and 5'8" or 5'6" from Poland, but 5'8" from Austria, Australia, the Soviet Union, Canada, and Sweden.
Ted, what this means is probably that it could be one of the top performances of the evening, certainly in the top five. I would guess probably with the skaters to come about fourth, but 5'8" is very difficult to beat.
Excellent marks across. course, for technical. Let's see what his marks now for artistic impression are going to be. And they, in most cases, are down just a little bit. He did so much, but as you pointed out, the program is still to be rounded out. But that is by far the top program so far in this free skating.
5-7, 5-7, 5-8, 5-6. Thank you.
Remember, certainly for Kurt Browning, you know, Kurt, a lot of guys say they're going in the woods to wrestle a grizzly bear, but they don't do it. You never denied the fact you were going to try the quad.
No, it was a part of the program. It was part of the everyday training at home. And I think the trick was just to make it part of the training at home. And now that it's become a reality, it's and relax and believe it.
Have they told you that the ISU has viewed it, officially approved it?
It's real.
What's it feel like to be making history?
I haven't sunk in yet. I spent the last couple of months training, downplaying the quadruple, making it just for another jump. Now that I can relax and enjoy it, it hasn't hit me yet, so I'm still waiting.
Mind you, that's not all. You've got an incredible contest.
It just seemed to roll after that. The ball just kept bouncing, and the audience just went crazy. And everywhere I looked, it was red and white, and the audience just took me through the rest of the program, which is good, because half my concentration was gone.
What Toller and I couldn't really understand is how, knowing you're going to go out there and attempt that quad, and it's sort of a history-making thing, skating in front of all these magnificent guys, you seemed very calm, were you?
Yeah, actually I was. I was more looking forward to this than I was the short program yesterday, and it showed yesterday. It wasn't a clean short program. And so I thought, no, there's a reason why I came over to Budapest, and that's to skate and have fun, and so that's what I'm going to do. And the audience sure helped. They made it fun.
It's great to have that big crowd, isn't it?
It's super, especially when they're all Canadians. It seemed like it tonight.
Well, you thrilled the whole works of us. Our sincere congratulations.
Oh, thank you very much.
Goodness knows what's in front of you, Kurt. It was just great.
We're going to get better.
Well, I'll...